Welcome to Tablet Talk, presented by Supercuts. I got Evan Rodrigues with me, and you've been pretty hot lately, so the puck seems to be going to net. Anything different that you're doing?
They're just starting to find their way in the back of the net for me.
Well, this, I feel, this assist here against Boston shorthanded really got you going. The no-look pass to Johan Larsson starting from a penalty kill position.
Scandy makes a great play up to Larry earlier on. As soon as he gets it, you can see four guys down low. And as we go up, I just try to look at the goalie as much as I can. I know where Larry is. And Pasternak there actually does a pretty good job of staying in the middle. And he doesn't bite on the fake, but he puts a stick in towards the skates. And the puck just goes on the front end of his toe. And Larry, when he gets it, he does a great job of not stick handling. Rask actually does a really good job of getting across. He doesn't bite on it. But Larry does a great job of corralling it, not stick handling. And it's a great shot. He goes high with it and ends up for a good shorthanded goal for us.
At what point do you know I'm going to do the fake pass?
Pretty much as soon as I get the puck on the right side on a 2-on-1. I know that if I can get the D to bite, that it's going to be a pretty easy goal. And it's something I enjoy doing. So as soon as I get it on the right side, that's why I kind of hesitate and wait a little bit for Larry to catch up, because I know I want to make that play to him.
Now, you're saying the D didn't bite on it, the goalie didn't bite on it, it just was an inch from not working.
Yeah.
So if we go to a few games later against New Jersey, you had enough confidence to say, I'm going to try it again, and this time, everybody bit on the face.
Yeah, right? Sobey does a great job making that outlet pass in the middle, and when I get the puck, Haber's going for change, and I look at him, and guys on the team know that I love to do this play, so he jumps up. And
he was exhausted, too. He had been there for a while.
But he knew, and their guy does actually a great job, so as soon as I feel him, I kind of go, uh-oh, and have to make this play, and this is what I like to do, is if you can go back a little bit, you want the defenseman to turn and read the shot, so as soon as his stick goes forwards, it gives me the whole lane, and then I get the goalie right there to drop his right knee, and then as a goalie, you can't pivot really that way, and Haber has a tap in.
It's not that hard of a shot, but he's got to hit the net. You have to put it on his tape, right?
Exactly, yeah.
Sometimes equipment malfunction may happen against Carolina. You block a shot, and tell us what happened here.
I go down to block it, and as soon as I do, I turn around, and you can see my blade go flying, and I turn my head, and I see it, and immediately I'm like, uh-oh. I've always watched other guys do this, and I'm like, man, if that ever happened to me, like, I know I'm going on one edge, and I'm just trying to, like, go inside,
power
outside,
pull, in, yeah, power,
inside, outside, inside, outside, and I make it all the way to the bench, and then, you know, I think I have it, and I get really excited. So I'm like, okay, last one, and I'm going to put my foot down and step off, but still, there's no blade in that skate, so as soon as I do, I wipe out, and then for some reason I try to do the same thing, get back up on that right skate, and I wipe out again, and then I just hop off, and the tuck ended up breaking on my skate, so they tried to pop the blade back in and wouldn't go, so I had to switch skates.
Well, Evan, hopefully you won't have equipment malfunction and you'll have many more nice passes and goals. So thank you for coming by on Tablet Talk, presented by Supercuts. Tablet Talk is presented by Supercuts. Save time, check in online for your next haircut today.